guys, how's it going? Jeremy Donson here with thedrumprofessor.com. Today we're going to be going over Just Like You by 3 Days Grace. So check it out. Notice at the beginning it starts abruptly. Unless you put a click track in front of it, then you're just gonna have to pretty much guess when you're gonna start, or if you're looking at it on, you know, on a certain, I don't know, if you have a timer or a clock, or you can tell by a video or something, then you could tell where it starts. But just for simplicity, we're gonna let it go da 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 start. So one and two and start. Okay, so once it does that, you can start. Now, if you want to time it on your own or put a click track in front of it, absolutely, more than welcome. But just for purely making it simple, we're going to wait for it to go, dot, 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 come in. Okay? So once we come in, we're going to play, or once the music starts, rather, we're going to play three measures. On the fourth measure, we're going to crash. The beat is very, very simple. It's bass, bass, snare, hi-hat. And everything has a hi-hat here. So bass, bass, snare, and. Bass, bass, snare, and. Very simple. At speed. That's it. So let's try this with music. We're gonna count. It's very easy to count too, because every time the guitar goes da 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 da, that's one. Two da 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 da. Three da 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 da. Four, you crash on four. Check it out. Okay, so on four, we're gonna crash with the bass drum. Now, nothing changes here. So think of it like this. Instead of going bass, bass, snare, and, we're gonna replace the hi-hat with the crash cymbal. That's it. That's the only difference you're doing, but you're gonna find it actually changes a bit. Muscle memory, I'm gonna have to practice that. Unless you're used to it, then obviously you just play it. But so let's say we're in the fourth measure here. Bass, snare, and. Again, just think of it like this. You're just hitting the crash instead of the hi-hat. So that's on fourth measure. Once you do that, then you do two basses by itself and crash with the snare. You're gonna do that two times. So putting it together, fourth measure. Okay, now after the bass, bass, crash, we're gonna crash back into one and do the exact same thing again. We're gonna do this twice, and then the third time we do it again. I'll go over that with you here in just a second, too. So there's three times that we do this. Okay, here we go. With music. Just to review real quick here, once you do this in fourth measure, you're going to crash back into it again, just like you entered the fourth measure. So you start the fourth measure like this, then crash back in. So bass, bass, crash, bass, bass, crash, crash, bass, snare, and bass, bass, snare. And now be very careful that when you do this, bass, bass, snare. Not a very, a very common mistake is to do this. Crash, bass, bass, snare. And it adds an extra bass, therefore you're off time because you added an extra beat where it doesn't go. So be sure. So it's going to do this a total of three times. You're going to do this fill, then we switch to the floor tom. Check it out. Once you finish that section, you're going to do the floor tom here. Now, what we do on the floor tom, this is the easiest way I can explain it to you, I feel, is instead of doing this, you're going to do the exact same thing, but your right hand's now on the floor tom. That's literally the only difference. Your right hand's on floor tom instead of hi-hat. You're doing the same thing. Now, after the second snare drum, you're gonna hit the high tom twice and then crash back in. So doing it slowly. Just like that. Now you're gonna do it two times with the crash. The third time you go tom tom, then you're gonna come back here again and do a fill and then exit out into the chorus. Okay, so putting this together, let's say from the end of the third set here. One, two, three, four. So once you do the last tom tom here, one, two, three, four, four on the snare and floor tom. Okay guys, so I hope you really enjoyed this song. I know I really like this song. It's a lot of fun, and it's not some insanely crazy hard song to do. It's pretty fun. So I hope you guys enjoyed it, and if you like this and you want to see more videos or even actually jam out with me, let me know. I'm offering a free half-hour jam session with me to see where you're at and how to get you to the next skill level in 1 month and just to have some fun. So if you'd like to do that, let me know. Message me. And we'll schedule it in. Thanks, guys.